Good morning. Welcome to Church of the Valley and happy Father's Day to all of you. Those of you who are here in the room, those of you who are watching on YouTube, we just want to wish you a very, very happy Father's Day today. And we'll talk about that a little bit more later in the service. But for now, I just want to welcome you. I want to welcome all of you. We're so blessed and privileged for those of you who are watching out on Facebook and YouTube that you have chosen this morning to watch our service. We know there's lots of services out there who are streaming now, especially because of COVID. So thank you to all of you who are watching and for all of you that have come out this morning. We just want to thank you for being here. As you can tell, your pastors are here today. Pastor Dennis and Mindy are in Idaho celebrating Father's Day with their kids. So we're glad that Pastor Dennis is able to celebrate with Megan and Amelia and Mark and Mindy up in Idaho. They will be back next Sunday, so let's just give them a great welcome back. Many of you haven't been able to make it out. Fortunately, California has dropped all those guidelines, so you can come to church now. So come on back next week and just bless your pastors as they return and worship with us together. Let's just pray. God, I thank you so much for this morning. I thank you that we have the privilege to be in this place, Lord, the privilege to worship you with all of our hearts, all of our minds, all of our souls, God. We just give this morning to you. We pray for all the dads out there that they will feel blessed this morning, that they will feel loved, that they will feel honored. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to read to you this morning from Psalm 112. It said, "Blessed are those who fear the Lord, who find great delight in his commands. Their children will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches are in their houses, and their righteousness endures forever. Even in darkness, light dawns for the upright. For those who are gracious and compassionate and righteous, good will come to those who are generous and lend freely, who conduct their affairs with justice. Surely the righteous will never be shaken. They will be remembered forever. They will have no fear of bad news. Their hearts are steadfast, trusting in the Lord. Their hearts are secure. They have no fear. In the end, they will look in triumph on their foes. They have freely scattered their gifts to the poor. Their righteousness endures forever. Their horn will be lifted high in honor." Amen. Isn't that what prayer for all of us, for all of you dads and for moms and for just people in general? You don't have to be a mom or a dad for that to apply. So we're going to spend some time now in worship to the Lord. If you guys want to stand with me. Oh, 1 minute. Not really. We got Dolores, we got Johnny, we got all of you out there. So let's just spend this time focusing on the Lord. Amen. Thank you. not here yet, so I'll say it again. Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to all of you here. Happy Father's Day to all of you out in Facebook and YouTube land. We honor you fathers today. And I was telling my husband I was kind of excited because there's some things I've always wanted to say on Father's Day. Although I had the chance, but I never took it. But right now I'm going to take the chance because I have something on my heart. And I always do every Father's Day that comes around. This always is in the back of my heart, my mind. So first of all, happy Father's Day. It's a special day. We want to honor and we want to celebrate you. We are so thankful for every one of you. And we realize that there are so many men out there, not just here, but everybody that's going to be watching, and you'd be surprised how many people actually watch those YouTube videos. That's quite a large number. So I don't know who's out there listening today, but I know you're all in different stages of your fatherhood. There's a lot of dads out there. You're doing an amazing job with your kids. Some of them are little. You're running around with them, and you're exhausted, and you're tired, and you're teaching them t-ball, and you're teaching them playing with their dollhouses. Some of them are grown, and you're still there to be their friend and to guide them. But you've been there. You've been a part of their lives. You've been there for your kids. And to all of you dads, we at Church of the Valley, we honor you. There's others of you out there that maybe you've stepped up, and you've taken on a fatherly role for some kids that aren't your own. Happens a lot. Maybe there's a niece, maybe there's a nephew, maybe there's a lady down the street, a single mom, and you've stepped up and you've been there for that child. And for those fathers out there, we thank you. Some of you this morning, maybe it's not such a happy Father's Day. Maybe you're grieving. Maybe you're grieving the loss of a child. Maybe you're grieving the loss of your own father. Maybe he's gone now to be with the Lord. Maybe you have a strange relationship with your father. Father's Day isn't always a super happy time for many people. And for those of you, we as Church of the Valley, we mourn with you. And finally, some of you, there's two here at least, and many out that are watching, that are yet to be fathers. But someday you will be. Perhaps, maybe you'll choose not to be. Either way, we at Church of the Valley, we pray for you. We pray for your futures, we pray for your future children, your future relationships. And finally, the most important thing that I want to remind you of, for men and women alike, we have a God, just like that song just said, that deserves to be our father. Deserves? Desires. That's the word. He desires to be our father. And all we have to do is reach out to him. He's just a prayer away, a word away. So wherever you are on your journey as a father, whether you have, you're a dad right now, whether you're grieving someone you've lost, whether you are yet to be a father, or you're not a biological father, but you've stepped up there for somebody, we appreciate you. And God the Father wants to be your father more than any of those different relationships. All you have to do is reach out to him. And so today, doing things a little bit different, may never be this way again, but today we are giving a gift, not just to the fathers, but to all the men in this room and boys. So if you dads, men, if you would stand up, Kevin's gonna give you a little gift, and we just want to honor you this morning. You are all a blessing to this church. You are all a blessing to your pastors. Like I said earlier, they are celebrating Father's Day with their kids, and I know that they miss you this morning, and I know that their hearts are here. And we just want to honor you all. You may be seated after you get your little gift, but as men of this church, and whatever stage of your journey you're on, we just honor you this morning. Happy Father's Day. So Pastor Dennis has prepared a message for you. I know it's a message that is dear to his heart. He stayed after last Sunday and recorded this message that he wanted to share with you his heart this morning. So we're going to watch a recorded message from your pastor this morning.
Our Father's Day. Well, to get us started today, I want you guys to open up your Bibles, find the book of Matthew, and find Matthew chapter 6. We're going to take a week off and study 1 Peter, but today I want you to go to Matthew chapter 6. And I think this is a strange place to start for our Father's Day message, but as soon as you find it, Matthew chapter 6, and then find Matthew chapter 6, verse 5. And it says right here, "And when you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogue and on the street corners to be seen by men. I tell you the truth, they have received the reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to your Father, your Heavenly Father, who is unseen. Then your Father, who sees what is done, will reward you. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask Him. This then is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For if you forgive men when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their sins, your Father will not forgive you your sins." Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I praise you and thank you. Thank you truly are our Father, which art in heaven. And that we can come to you. We come to you because we have a relationship with you through the power of your Son, through the power of the Holy Spirit, and that, Lord, we look at you as being our Father, our Abba, our Daddy, our Papa. We receive you, Lord, as being the Father in our lives, even to those of us who have no fathers, to those of us who lost our fathers. And Father, I pray that today you will bless us with your word, with your wisdom, with your love, and with your truth. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You know, a couple years ago, I thought about how I had one of the toughest Father's Days I ever experienced because I had never had a Father's Day without my daughter. And I know it's very difficult to have a Father's Day without a father, but to be a father, not having your daughter with you, well, it's obvious today, I'm not with you right now. I'm actually spending the day with my daughter and my granddaughter. It still is making me think about what is important in life. Have you noticed that what we think is important sometimes, maybe God doesn't think is important? In culture, especially, I mean, just think. I just think that it's like, I feel like I just need to pray more and more because what the society is coming after us, how these things are just one after another, how everything that's happening around the world is happening in Israel, is happening in some of our cities across the United States. And I feel like, you know what, God? Show me what's important from your perspective. Show me what we need to do right now. You know, I feel like, so many times I feel like I'm afraid that I'll be wasting my life, wasting my energy, wasting on things that are not, that might seem important to me, but not important to God. You know, and I also thought that they might be important before, not, you know, my life is not important now. And now I've come down to the point where I only actually have three more work days, three more days of work on the job. So I'm praying more and more, and moment by moment. And sometimes it's just a short prayer to say, "Hey God, show me what to do next. Show me what I need to do this week. Show me where my life is going, and what I need to do, and how what's going on in my life." And I just think that, God, I need just to do showed me what was the difference between what's urgent and what's important. Especially not in life that I'm no longer going to be working for man. And so this week, pray God to show me the difference between what's urgent and what's important. And sometimes it's, you know, it is urgent, sometimes it is important. But I need God more and more to show me what's important. Because I know that I need to seek first the kingdom of God. I need to seek first the kingdom of God and seek this before I can just listen to this. I don't always know what it looks like, you know, what it looks like in my life at this very moment that it might be important or not important, but I know that God needs to direct me and guide me and give me the direction I need to go to do His will. I know that in my life, you know, I'm a pastor. I need to prepare sermons. I need to meet with people. On their level, you know, I'm a father. I have a daughter that normally lives 1,500 miles away. But I know this too. If I was to drop dead, there'd be another preacher here next week. But, you know, my daughter, she only has one dad. And it's true. You know, it's so true that some of the things that I thought were really important back in my 20s are now totally different now than my early 60s. And I realized that I need God more and more to show me what's important. Especially now since I'm retiring from a job. Retiring from a job that I've done for the last 30 years. You know, I need to be led by the Spirit to know what's important in this moment, in this season of my life. What is the priority of God for me? How am I to seek it out, my Heavenly Father? I love that song, Good Father. You know, to trust Him with my daughter, trust Him with my granddaughter. You know, have Him make me the father of destiny, even as I'm going to be the grandfather He's destined me to be. I want my daughter to say to me, "Well done, Father." So I'm talking today about, so that's where I'm at right now. So I'm talking today about our Heavenly Father. And that's why I read that passage from Jesus, Him introducing them to us, God as Father. You know, many of us were raised by fathers for crying. You know, they guided us the best they could. They gave us everything we needed. But no matter how good our fathers were, they're not perfect. People are not perfect. They make mistakes. You know, there are times they can let us down. Maybe not give us what we needed. Some fathers, you know, they mean well, but they weren't affectionate. They never told you that they loved you, that they were proud of you. You know, they corrected you. They made sure that you stayed on the right path, but then they didn't express their love. Most likely their fathers did the same thing to them. They never heard, "I love you." They never saw a model. And you can't give away what you don't have. A friend of mine back in high school, Rick Edinburgh, he was actually my next door neighbor too. And his father even worked at General Motors, worked with my Uncle Bill. Well, Rick's father, he struggled with alcohol. He was a good man, and he was fun to be with, fun to be around, until he started drinking. Then he became abusive. He became violent. And more than once, my friend, you know, he had to protect his mother and his sister from his father. And he would say, "Why do I have to deal with this? Why do I have a father that gets this way? He's great because he's drunk, but he loves to drink. He was one of those angry drunks." Most fathers, they never plan on the best of their children's lives. They didn't set out to make it more difficult. They didn't really want to pass down dysfunction. to them. And such as they may be affected all around them. You can't help it. You've been impacted by the people that raised you. But the good news is that our Heavenly Father, He has taken that all into account. He knew who your parents would be. He knew what you would be. He knew what you wouldn't get. He knew what wouldn't be fair. He's already designed a plan with this in mind to get you where He wants you to go, to get you into His will. And your Heavenly Father, He'll never let you down. He's the friend that sticks closer than the brother. And maybe your earthly father never gave you His approval, but our Heavenly Father, He says, you know, I'm proud of you. I love you. You're my son. You're my daughter. You're a masterpiece. You're a prized possession. You're fearfully and wonderfully made. Now, don't stay focused on what your earthly father did, or didn't do, or didn't give you. Don't live a bitter life because, you know, you may have been put at a disadvantage because of your earthly father. Start going to your Heavenly Father. As Jesus said, go to your Heavenly Father, which art in heaven. And when I say, you know what God's within us? You know, my dad wasn't around like your dad was. Or my dad was harsh. My dad was abusive. He didn't treat me right. If you start going to your Heavenly Father, you'll get your approval. You'll get your affirmation. You'll get your love from Him. Then despite what your earthly father did or didn't do, He will pay you back for the injustice. He will help you not only overcome, but He'll show you favor. As Jesus said, it is the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Our Heavenly Father takes good pleasure in making your wrongs right, giving you what your earthly father could never give you. Many night, we have a friend. We consider her an adopted daughter. She was raised in an unhealthy environment. Her mother passed away at 16 years old. And her father pretty much abandoned her at the same time. And without godly influence of her, you know, godly influence of her father, she fell into drugs. She fell into an unbearable existence. She felt alone and afraid. At 16 years old, she left the house and she went out on her own. All the odds were against her. She could have become a statistic. She could have passed down the same dysfunction. Psalm 68 says this, God will be the father to follow us. God sees when you don't have someone watching after you. He sees when you've been put into an unfair situation where you didn't have a choice, where you were born into it. And this young lady, if she had given her life to her which is 12 years old, through the influence of a godly grandmother, but she didn't have a home life to sustain her. Then one day, on the verge of death, she was rescued by God, by a godly couple. A godly couple helped her get her teen challenge. And there she made the decision that she wasn't going to pass down the same dysfunction to her children. She was going to break this generational curse. In the natural, she didn't have a chance. With her background, her poor home life, or her drug abuse, or God, where she has left God out of her life, let her come to God, the Father of the Bibles. He began to change her circumstances, and she came into our lives. And He started watching after her like she was His own daughter. Now today, she's not only extremely blessed, but she's raising her children in a loving, healthy, faith-filled Christian home. Her husband is a godly husband, a godly father. And she just had her third child. God the Father helped her break the generational curse and start a generational blessing. Many of us approach Father's Day with mixed emotions. But some people have hands-on fathers, and are more available and interested in their lives. Others have somewhat distant or disinterested fathers. Others still were abandoned by their fathers altogether. And some have fathers who have died. But one thing we all have in common, no matter what kind of dad we have or have had, is that we have a Father in heaven. And regardless of how your father on earth has treated you, you have a Father in heaven who has always been there and will always be there for you. David wrote this: "When my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord will take care of me," in Psalm 27:10. We have a Heavenly Father, and a way to communicate with them is through prayer. But Jesus brought this up in Matthew chapter 6. The greatest prayer that was ever prayed is often called the Lord's Prayer. This is where Jesus taught us to pray. He taught us to pray, said, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." In fact, it says from evil one. In Ephesians, in some versions, "For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen." Now the thing about this, to address God's Father, that was a revolutionary thought. Especially in the Jewish minds. The Hebrews, they feared God. And they attached such sacredness to his name, they wouldn't even utter his name. And so in the Old Testament, God is referred to as Father, fewer than seven times of them. And when he is, it's either indirectly or rather remotely. In fact, when Jesus referred to God as his Father, he was accused of blasphemy. One of the reasons he was crucified was because he spoke of the special relationship that he had with his Father. And now, because of his death and resurrection, we can have that relationship too. And after rising from the dead, he said to Mary Magdalene, he said, "I'm ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and to your God." We need to view God not the way we view an earthly dad. We need to view God as he is presented in Scripture. We need to see him as Jesus saw him. Jesus claimed that his Father in heaven is our Father. We need to take advantage of that relationship and know that, that's the same Father Jesus has as our Father. And not only does the Bible tell us to address him as Father, we're to do so in an intimate way. The apostle wrote this so you have not received the Spirit that makes you fearful slaves. Instead, you have received God's Spirit when he adopted you as his children. Now we call him Abba. We call him Abba, Father. Romans chapter 8, verse 15. This word Abba, speaks of intimate speech. It speaks of, like, as I call Father, Daddy. Or Papa. The idea is that an affectionate relationship. I loved it when my daughter called me Daddy because I knew that she called me Daddy because she loved me. I loved it when my granddaughter calls me Papa because, it's just Papa. When she was just starting to talk, she would lift up her hands and say, "Papa, up, Papa." That's what we need to do now. Say, "Up, Papa." Right? She'd say, "Up, Papa," when she said, when she wanted to be picked up. She wanted to get up, or she wanted to get off her high chair or something. How can you resist that? How can our Father in heaven resist that when we say, "Up, Papa"? Up, Papa. Father, right? If you want to know what kind of Father we have in heaven, we look at Jesus. Because Jesus says, "He who has seen me has seen the Father." He also said, "If you had known me, you would have known my Father." You think about this, just look at Jesus when he was blessed with little children. He'd bring them into his arms, he'd gather around them, he'd bless them.
that Jesus was screaming, when tears were streaming down his face at the grave of his friend Lazarus. Just look at Jesus when he was watching the disciples' feet in the upper room. That is what your Heavenly Father is like. Getting really close to Jesus is really getting really close to the Father, our Heavenly Father. I want to say, Up, Father. Papa. Abba, Father. That's a relationship because we have a relationship with Him because we are His children. We are His chosen one. We're the ones who sit at His feet, who learn from Him, who yearn Him. I want to close this message today by saying this. If you join us today, and you're not sure if you're a child of God or the Father, you can become a child of God right now. Wonderful thing is that this. You can become a child of God right now. This ain't church, this ain't moms, this ain't hours. They happen with just a flash. I don't know if you can even measure the time. And then maybe today, you know, you came to church. You became with certain skepticism. You came here this morning, perhaps you're here this morning. You're starting to think, you know, I don't know how everybody believes this. But you know what? Through the power of the Holy Spirit, I know that the light just went on. You know, and you just realize in an instant, this is all true. This is all true. This is what I've been looking for. This is what I've been longing for. It's because God wired you that way. To know Him as your Heavenly Father. And Jesus, He showed this love for us by going to the cross and dying for your sins. And paying for your sins. And then rising again from the dead. And now Jesus, He stands at the door of your heart. He's knocking on the door and He says, you know, if you hear my voice today, open the door and I'll come in. Would you like to have your sin forgiven? Would you like to have this relationship with God that I've been talking about? Would you like to know that your Father in heaven is personal? To know Him in a personal and intimate way? And it can happen for you right now. And we're going to pray, and I'm going to extend an invitation to you to believe in Him and ask Him to come into your life. Because the Bible says this, whoever will call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And here's an opportunity for us to do this. And Father, right now, before we do this, I just pray, Father, just say thank you, Lord, for your love. Thank you for being in our Heavenly Father. Thank you for being there for us. Thank you for sending your Son, Jesus, that we can understand what it's like to have a Father. And Lord Jesus, thank you for coming and dying for us. And paying for our sins, and interceding for us, and for your care for us. And now I pray, Father, that anyone here, anyone watching, Lord, that you just help them see their need for you. Help them see that you are the Heavenly Father who loves them, who cares about them, who wants eternal life for them. Right now, as we pray, if anyone wants Christ in their life, to have that in their life, just pray this prayer right after me. Pray it right after me. You pray it out loud, and just believe in your heart. Say, Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner, but I know that you're the Savior who loves me, who died for me, who rose again from the dead. Come into my life now. Jesus, I choose to follow you as my Lord, my Savior, as my God and my friend. From this moment forward, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, I want to be the first. If you pray that prayer today, I want to be the first to tell you, welcome to the family of God. And God bless you. It's time to celebrate. Amen.
You're a good, good Father.
God is your good Father, and He desires that relationship with all of you. We're going to, Mel, I know they told you you didn't have a microphone, but do you mind just coming up here and using this one? Mel's going to pray for our offering today, and then as you're leaving, you can just drop your offering off with him, but I'm going to have Mel pray for that.
Almighty God in heaven, we thank you today, Lord, for giving us this day the opportunity to come and join our hearts together in praising and worshiping your name, O God. God, we thank you that we thank you for all your love and care, your abundant mercy and grace to each one of us. God, we thank you that you gave us a generous heart of giving. Bless the tithes and offering today, Lord. Bless the giver and all that may not be able to share this time for any reason, oh God. We thank you, Lord, that you are continuing to bless the fathers of today, Lord. Bless all those men that may also be serving as the father head of the home, oh God. Thank you for all your blessings. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
God bless you guys. Don't forget, your pastors will be back next week, so come on out and welcome them home. And I pray that you guys have a great week. In Jesus' name, God bless you.